In the not too distant future, next Sunday AD, there was a guy named Joe, not too different from you or me. He worked at his Gizmonic Institute, just another face in a red jumpsuit. He did a good job cleaning up the place, but his bosses didn't like him, so they shot him into space. We'll send the cheesy movies, the worst we can find. He'll have to sit and watch them all, then we'll monitor his mind. Now keep in mind, Joe can't control where the movies begin or end, because he used those special parts to make his robot friends.
Robot will call Cabot. Gypsy.
Hi, girl.
Tom Servo.
What a cool guy.
Cool.
If you're wondering how he eats and breathes and other science facts, then repeat to yourself, it's just the show. I should really just relax. For Mystery Science Theater 3000.
Well, you won't be needing this anymore.
Hey, wait, that's my body. That's got some of my favorite parts.
Oh, come on.
I don't want to be part of this dumb nightmare doubleman ad, Joel.
Yeah. Oh, bite me. You're the thing with two heads. It's fun.
I call Ray Milan.
Oh, great. That makes me Rosie Greer.
Oh, come on. A fella could do a lot worse than be a star lineman for the L.A. Rams.
Yeah, but just happens to be in touch with his feminine side.
Let me tell you something, Pinbeak. Your mouthwash just ain't making it.
Oh, yeah? Well, this body really stinks. Look at these tiny little arms. What are they good for? Eating corn on a cob?
Joel, I really, really hate this thing with two heads idea.
Well, yeah, stop us before we kill again, Joel.
Well, how about this? Well, you're the Odd Couple 1999.
Say. Cool. Sometime earlier, Crow's body had thrown him out, requesting that he never return again. Can two heads live in the same body without driving each other crazy?
Felix!
No, Oscar, it's not spaghetti, it's linguine.
Now it's good.
Four, three, I don't two, think so. We'll be right back. All right, come here, you little waffle stomper.
Get him, let him have it. Hey, wait, that's me. That's my body.
Look at my fat little fireplug of a body. It's humiliating, Joe.
I know. You look like George Wendt.
Oh, come on, you guys. He's just a little husky, that's all.
Oh, look at him run, the stupid jerk. Traitor, you get back here with... Say, look at the cute butt on me, will ya? It's not half bad, is it, guys? Woo-hoo.
Hey, you're getting into a real weird area now, Servo.
Yeah, Tom, I don't know if that's natural, buddy.
Gentlemen, can't a robot admire his own back porch without being thought of as a strange
type of... Cool it. Marky Mark and the Funky Bunch, I'm calling.
Well, I guess the big news around here is Dr. Clayton Forrester died. Passed away 2-3 days ago. You can imagine it's a little hectic, what with the funeral arrangements and the business to attend to, and the mole people have been a great source of strength.
Wow, what happened?
He was, dead. I guess that's what caused it all. Well, you know, the upshot of all this is, I'm gonna be in charge around here from now on. What a way to get a promotion, huh? Oh, hi.
Why don't you forge ahead with this week's invention exchange, Joel? I'm going to be busy with Frank for a second.
Ooh, you think you'll kill him?
Hush, child. Well, sirs, our invention today looks like an ordinary prop radio, except that its tuner only picks up channels from old sitcoms and movies. Like, for example, this is set up for the Plot Point channel.
We interrupt this broadcast to bring you a special bulletin. The Midvale Bank has just been robbed by two armed hooligans.
And then there's the incredibly plot-specific news channel.
This just in, apparently the Harlem Globetrotters are lost at sea and thought to be washed up on an uncharted desert isle.
And, of course, the generic teen dance music station. This one song has been playing on this one station for over 50 years.
Yeah, this was danced to by the likes of Chip Douglas and Marsha Brady, even Jethro Bodine. What do you think, sirs?
Here, it's going to start hurting soon. Take one of these for pain, and the red ones should reduce the swelling.
Thanks, Steve.
Oh, very clever, Holly Hobby. Now taste the red-hot steel of Dr. Clayton Firebrand Forrester. The punching bag has always had a sound principle behind it. Frank?
Yes, that it's fun to beat Boffo the Clown savagely and repeatedly till the Boffo's bleeding from the ears. But then, alas, the thrill is gone. Yeah, the fire goes out of your belly. You need something new to stimulate your imagination.
That's right. That's why we've invented these hateful punching bags with images of characters from the Renaissance Festival. For instance, there's the Rat Catcher.
Excuse me, sir. Is that your head or did your neck throw up?
Oh, bite me, Frodo.
And there's the ever-popular Leather Mug Maker.
Please, sir, sample my wares.
Sample my fist, you community theater reject.
Lovable Harlequin. I am Harlequin.
I am your worst nightmare. $23 to get in. Huzzah my butt, you satin-suited, Tolkien-reading loser.
That's enough, Frank. Well, Joel, your experiment this week is a sweetmeat replete with empty-headed teens, fast cars, and a cute little lizard. It's called the Giant Gila Monster, and it will make you hurt, or my name's not Earl Scheib. Enjoy.
There are.
Oh, head snapped right on, real nice.
For it hurts. Unexplored region.
A little stiff.
Bleak and desolate. Where no human ever goes.
Macy's?
And no light is ever seen.
Only you can prevent forest fires.
It is as though the land had been posted by God.
Roasted. It's God roasted for great taste.
It is in these lonely areas of impenetrable forest and dark shadows.
Barnabas Collins.
That the Gila Monster still lives.
Shelley Winters?
How large the dreaded Gila Monster grows, no man can say.
Hey!
Oranges, porges, who cares? There ain't no rhyme for oranges.
I usually don't touch cheeks on the first date.
Richie Potsy, no!
Rolling, rolling, rolling.
Bad movie? You're soaking in it.
Hey!
Hava, La Gila, Hava, La Gila, Hava.
You know what? This kind of looks like a modified I Dream of Jeannie Intercept font, doesn't it?
No. It's a Bewitched Sans Serif.
No, I think you're thinking of a Patty Duke show bold condensed, actually.
You know, if it was italicized, I'd swear it was Jack Webb.
Good call.
It's Dom Casual, actually.
Tonight, K-E-L-L-O-Dead.
And featuring Jack No, nickname Marshall.
Oh, Don.
Hey, look, Wee Willie Risser, my favorite John Ford film.
I have to do that.
I don't get it.
Oh, great. The Gila Monster's fictitious. What a downer.
The only person living or dead. Oh, Kent Curtis, Festus from Gunsmoke.
Well, now, Matthew,
the best you each morning.
Not.
We now join Gila Monster, already in progress.
Oh, it's a scene from Truth or Dare.
Hey, the kids are meeting in a barber shop.
Hey, who put their comb in my coke?
Hey, it's Catherine Hepburn's son.
Dear Eliza, I'll get that door and roof fixed real soon. Thank you, love.
Hey, Jane.
Hey, what are you doing?
Hi. Hi. What's that? Could be charging you with an entertainment
bag. Hey, one at a time. We've only got one boom mic.
Hey, how are the new clocks on the bomb?
Hey, here comes Sabrina and the Gooby Ghoulies.
It's the magnificent men in their jaunty jalopies.
Aaron, don't touch me. I'm all made up. Please.
Hey, gang, we're past the room limit. Some of us have to move into the elevator.
Where's Pat and Liz? I thought we'd be the last ones here.
They're probably out booging around somewhere. Maybe they broke
boom!
Down.
Not in his heat. I worked on it myself.
That wouldn't make any difference if he goofed a speed shift or something.
Oh, shut up, Pee-wee. Yeah.
Just the one to do it.
Oh, wonderful. What kept you so long, Lisa?
Oh, Mr. Wheeler smoked two cigars at the table after dinner, and I could not get out of the ship.
Whoa, honey, speak English, will you?
Pa did not come home for dinner. That's why his father was so upset.
Here, drink this. It'll make you feel American.
Here's old man Harris.
That fellow has a jewel of a car.
Let me think about that.
Well,
okay.
Well.
Hyman, wait here in the car.
Looks like this is where old jalopies go to die.
Hey!
It's TV's lovable string bean!
You
want to
sell that deuce?
My little deuce coupe, you don't know what I got.
Why, you fellas always after me to buy my car. That 32 is the ideal stock to convert to a bomb.
Why do you guys always throw me down and steal my wallet?
Buying a car, son, is just like getting married. Or going to New York City.
New York City!
Everybody ought to do it once, but get the room. Nobody ought to do it twice.
I'm available for parties and bar mitzvahs.
I can get you a good price on that.
Again with a finger.
Paid $695 for that car 26 years ago. 10 years ago, wasn't worth a dime. Last month, I turned down $100 for it. When it gets back up to $695 again, I'll sell it.
Just beat him up and take the piece.
Hey, Spook, give me a snort of that there soda.
Excuse me, that one just slipped out.
Hey, gang, you know this would be Lisa's first trip to a drive-in?
Oh, we have drive-in to France.
Oui, c'est les Jerry Lewis movies.
With my brother on his motor scooter.
Looks like he's filling the bottle.
Who put soda pop in my soda pop?
Hey, let's go do some crimes, man.
Hey, Chase. If the road's clear, I'll drag you to Bartonell's Corner.
Drag me? Yeah, I'll get the tow chain.
You still running on that old rubber?
Old rubber? No.
Hey, Spooks. When Pat and Liz get here, will you tell them that we went to the drive-in and for them to catch up? Thank you.
We sure will.
Ding. And I'll give you $150.
To take acting lessons.
You're talking like my foot's asleep.
Okay, enough said, old timer.
What are you playing with, kids?
Oh, it's Red Man juice.
Oh, that guy cracks me up. I don't know, do you?
One Adam 12. What are you doing in Wisconsin?
Selznick International Pictures presents...
I'm Sebastian Cabot, and this is Ghost Story.
The Death Bear Program!
Trouble, Mr. Willis. Pat didn't come home last night.
He didn't?
No, evidently was out with Liz Humphreys. She didn't come home either.
Oh?
When you do, Sheriff.
I want you to find out why. And don't leave a stone unturned in doing so. Do I make myself clear?
I understand, Mr. Wheeler.
That's a well-fitting suit.
Rex reported last night. Your son, Pat, he's about 19, isn't he?
That's right.
As teens go, yes.
He's a year older than I was when I got married.
You think they eloped?
No, they can't elope. They're fruit, get it?
Oh, there.
I didn't say that. But if they were out together all night, you better hope they have.
This is a missing persons report, and I want to know what you're going to do about it.
Well, I'll send in an APB on both of them and the car. I don't think it'll do much good if they went off to get married. They'd already be across the state line.
Uh-oh. Why, if he got married, I'll wring his
neck.
That
Jerry Lee, he's done it again.
You ask me, it's that Chase Winston. He's older than the others. Sets them all wrong. Why, he's got more influence on Pat than I have.
Hooker's a good
Chase cop. Winston does more about keeping them in line than getting them in trouble, and I know. He's supported his mother and sister ever since his dad died on one of your drill rigs. Your son could take a page out of his book, Mr. Wheeler.
When I get through with my son, he won't have a book left. Now, you locate him or I'll have your job.
If you want to be the only peace officer in 10,000 square miles and 1,000 miles of road, you're welcome to it.
This is my world, and welcome to it.
I'll do everything I can to locate both of them.
Go on home. They're waiting for you.
Hi, Sheriff.
Wish I were. These.
Was this the Misfits all
got
of a sudden?
A set of wheels.
Yeah, new to me. That clunker I had, I'd be chasing you boys on a bicycle in a couple of days.
Oh, come on, Sheriff. Outside of Pat Wheeler, we haven't had a ticket in our gang in 8 months.
Oh, I was just kidding.
How much for the macaroni and cheese?
What's the mileage on it?
Oh, about 35,000. Tony bought it from the state. Those lucky stiffs on highway get a new car every year.
Let me have it for a couple of days and I'll tune it up for you.
You choke it off so I could never catch it.
You couldn't catch that deuce of mine right now. Now, let me have that patrol car. I'll turn it into a slingshot that'll catch anybody.
A Joe Namath netted slingshot.
What do you dream about?
Just between us, Liz Humphreys and Pat Wheeler didn't get home last night.
They were supposed to meet us at the drive-in, but they didn't show up. We wondered what happened.
Heck, Ramsey!
Are they in any kind of trouble?
Oh.
What do you mean?
You know.
You know, like Warren Beatty and Annette Bening?
No, I don't think so.
Chase, level with me.
You think I'm pretty?
I'm almost positive they weren't in any trouble. I'd know.
Mechanic's intuition.
You think they might have run off to get married?
Well, they've been going steady for over a year now. And I know they talked about it, but...
Well, sir, person's got urges.
Not like for right now.
Did Pat have any money stashed?
Geez, what is he, the Shell Answer Man?
Yeah, some.
Like how much?
Well, he was talking about getting a new blower and a mill.
What?
About $500.
Where did he get that kind of money?
Bake sale.
Saved it. His old man gives him a good allowance when he's not mad at him.
What bank does he use?
Hooterville Savings and Loan.
Well, he's had to find out.
He could have been saving if he got married, couldn't he?
Funny. I guess he could do whatever he wants with it.
Looks like the garage of Dr. Calgary.
His old man has put him down flat.
I know. But Pat's smart enough to provide for himself till the old man cooled off.
Sanctuary! Sanctuary!
Slow down. Did you check the hospitals?
Yeah. Where could I find the rest of the gang?
Gangland?
I don't know about Bob and Gordy, but Chuck and Rick went over to Easton. They wanted to check with the Wheelcats about next Saturday night's platter party.
Next Saturday night?
Yeah.
You warn the gang I'll be cruising that pass that night.
Say.
No dragon.
He just bought those red satin pumps.
You got any postcards from those two? Let me know.
Say, nice J. Crew barn jacket.
Meanwhile, at Grandma's Lake Cottage in Frederick, Wisconsin.
Hi, Sheriff.
Hey, Mr. Douglas, I got those bodies buried just in time.
Well, they were just waiting by the door.
Junior Sable.
Hello, Sheriff.
I don't have
a word
for you,
She's a good girl, Sheriff.
God, you're ugly.
I ain't worried.
How come you drove around the truck all night, then?
Well, let's just say I'm acquainted with the night.
You don't think she might have eloped, do you?
Could be. She's pretty close-mouthed about her affairs.
Maul the likes of Wheeler ain't marrying our kind of folks.
We're just simple white trash folk.
You don't have a phone, so I just dropped around to let you know I'm doing everything I can.
We know that, Sheriff. We sure do appreciate it.
Oh.
Sorry, Liz, you were so much trouble.
Never any trouble looking after kids.
Let me know if I can help, Sheriff. Yeah, we've got to quit worrying this way. We've got to trust in the Lord. We've got
crazy
to
Amish folk.
Morris, morning, Sheriff.
Let me smell your breath.
Hey.
Nice uvula.
Okay, go ahead.
Okay.
Set me free, booze. I need you.
Hi, Chase.
Hi.
Still got your knee up, I see.
Yeah, she's all set.
Good.
My boy, that's one trip I'm glad I don't have to make very often.
Stuff heavy, I'll help you unload.
No.
Ready, and up.
Hot. Wheeler's sinking another oil well and he sprayed a fire when it comes in.
What?
What the heck are you saying?
Four quarts of natural glycerin out there in that kit. He wants us to keep it out back in the storehouse.
Will Rogers' Follies will continue after this.
Oh, last winter, when number 21 came in, I made $100 for that stuff. Dad showed me how to use it.
Mom told you not to use it.
Ooh. It doesn't get nervous.
Well, I'm sorry I was late getting back. But with that cargo, I was afraid to do over 5 miles an hour.
Was English your first language?
It's not so dangerous as long as it's in a nitro case.
But I took these out of the case.
Holy smoke. You're lucky to be standing here talking about it. I'll put it in the
Don't go away, sir. Let's talk it through.
Oh, hi, Mom. Hey, don't get up. Here's your chili and your water.
Did we win the war, son?
Shut up, Mom.
Okay.
Yep.
Watch action this afternoon.
Get your knee up, boy. Come on.
Sheriff got a new patrol car. There we'll get a tune-up job out of that. Is that nitro safe out there?
Well, if it decides to blow, it's not safe anywhere.
Is it safe?
Hmm? When he's ringing?
I'll get it.
That's not our ring. No, it's the sheriff's. If there's been a wreck, I get a tow job out of it.
Oh,
also have a deal
wow.
with the ambulance if someone's hurt. You work all the angles, don't you, Chase?
Mr. Compton, I have to.
He's a geometry teacher.
Hello, Sheriff?
Yes. What are you wearing? I'm putting my knee up right now.
What kind of a car? Oh, it's a sedan. Pontiac,
sweet emotion.
It hurts pretty bad. Maybe you should get out there pretty quick. Stop the investigation.
Turn it off!
Yes.
I feel so dirty.
There's been a wreck 12 miles out of town. Where's the wrecker?
Home.
Oh.
I used the A-frame to build a doggone rock garden.
Oh.
Look, you take your car and keep the city wreckers off. I'll get our wrecker and follow you.
And we can clear away the wreckage of our sordid past.
N-Y-P-D.
Yeah, we know you're here. There's no one else in the county, and you use your siren.
Oh, they've got this angle parking thing all wrong.
See anything I can put my knee up on here, boy?
I wondered who was on that party line a while ago.
Well, it cost me to get on that line with you. I figured since it was on your call station anyway, you wouldn't care.
Yeah. That's a pretty good one.
Yeah.
Yeah, gee, looks like a cat climbed up in the grill. Woof.
This engine's still warm.
Say, did you see the skid marks out here? They go at a direct right angle to the direction of travel.
Hey, sounds like Robert Klein's around here.
No digs in the macadam either.
Sad, really.
Somebody was hurt in here. There's blood all over the upholstery.
Nothing escapes you, Obi.
I've already looked around. There's nobody here.
Real good?
Yeah, real good. Well, maybe somebody came by and picked them up. It could have been the people that called in.
Mm-hmm. No, they'd have said something.
Nope.
Then why didn't they wait?
People will go to the trouble to report an accident, but they won't stay around. Don't want to fill out the reports.
Yeah, nobody likes a lousy snitch.
What do you do now?
Well, I'll take the license number and the engine number. Call headquarters. Maybe they've got a line on them.
Our headquarters.
Hey, what are you looking at? That's official police property.
How are your headlights?
Fine. I don't have headlights.
Fine. Both of them burning?
Mm-hmm.
How many times have I warned you about getting that headlamp fixed?
About a cajillion, sir.
But the first time it was just a suggestion.
Seal beam only cost $4.
The tender headlight.
Had some unexpected expenses.
Oh? Jesse?
Yeah, the doctor said she'd be able to start walking again pretty soon and took all the money I had to make a part-down payment on her braces.
Gosh, the moonlight does crazy things to your hair, sir.
Well, you know, I think this is a complete washout.
These folks are dead. Not much else we can do.
You probably got a screwdriver.
No, but I got a Singapore sling.
Ba-boom.
It's just...
Oh. I don't think the insurance company has missed one of those headlamps.
Yeah, that guy's not going to miss his credit cards either, you know.
One, two, one. Out your
beak!
Ow, what about my
beak? Hey, you guys, quiet down. Hi, do you like to make money? Sure, we all do. Well, do you realize move aside. Do you realize you might have a gold mine sitting in that empty pantry or linen closet at home? Yeah, sure. Just do what I do and turn that empty closet space into a gold mine by turning it into a teen pavilion / barber shop, just like in today's movie, The Giant Gila Monster.
Woo! Solid gone, Jasper!
Come with Freaks, Daddy!
Kids, will you step aside? You guys in their teen lingo. You know, all you gotta do is clear away some of the more hazardous cleanser
Stock up on plenty of health, delicious and delicious snacks and beverages, and then tune in your prop radio into the appropriate teen dance tunes.
Big finish!
Oh, you make me sweat, Tommy.
Yeah, me too. Let's go get something cool and slippery from the stupid jerk.
Oh, good idea.
Hey, stupid jerk.
Tom, it's soda jerk. Would you guys straighten up and fly with me on this one? Come on, this is my sketch.
Okay.
All right, all Pops, shoot us a couple of Blue Floyds,
Yeah. What's a Blue Floyd?
Cramity, this guy.
Okay, Daddy, we'll talk you through.
Okay.
Just put 2 scoops of ice cream in a blender.
No, 3 scoops.
Three scoops.
Three scoops.
Add some malted milk.
Of ice cream?
Yep. And then fill it to the top with cool menthol barbicide.
Okay, yeah, and garnish with a cone.
Yeah.
Oh, come on, you guys. That's it. The fun time's over. This is my sketch. You guys never go along with me on these things. I stop. I quit it.
Come on, forget it.
Every time you guys, the robots, come up with some half-baked idea, I try to go along with it and be supportive. But the minute Joel has an idea for a presentation, in run the baby Teddy Ruxpins and spoil everything.
Okay, fine. Next time you can get your precious Gypsy to help you.
Hey, Gypsy, come here.
These two, nothing but trouble. Back after this.
It hurts.
It really hurts.
Be quiet. Don't let it happen again.
I'm gonna die.
It's young Jimmy Morrison as the Lizard King.
Here comes Fred Sanford.
I'm feeling mighty peckish. Snack time. Yeah.
Good afternoon, sir, madam. I'd like to show you the Encyclopedia Britannica if you'd just take a... Damn, I thought selling door-to-door was hard. Ooh.
I just love dining al fresco.
And that's the guy's name, al fresco, if you believe it. Yeah. I can't get that tune out of my head. I don't know.
The Road Company of Death of a Salesman, ladies and gentlemen.
I'll eat him with relish. Lizard jokes.
Fava beans.
Well, see every coop. I've been meaning to quit.
Hey.
It's a Montclair moment.
Wow. Hey, can I bum a smoke?
And for killing that salesman, you win the Samsonite luggage. Oh, have an accident?
No, thanks. Just had one.
Sorry. Car was stolen out of state, and the plates were stolen in state.
Insured by Allstate.
So whoever stolen it beat us, hurt or not, as long as they could navigate.
Yeah, I'm a poet, and I don't know
anything
it.
Anything else I can do here, Sheriff? If not, I'll get this on back to the garage.
Oh, go ahead. Chase, would you give me a hand?
I cinch up your own pants, Sheriff.
Pictures of those skid marks. You stand by them for a scan.
Skid marks? You're a sick man, Sheriff.
Wait, that's my car!
Let's see, I got tires, headlights. Now, if I could just get a roof.
Man, night falls fast in Tennessee.
Yeah, well. I'm guessing a Northwest flight passed overhead.
Entrapment. Yep. I smell a frame-up. Luggage gate.
Can I see your claim check, please? Yeah.
Trouble, Chase? No, Sheriff. Take a look.
That's an easy one. It's a suitcase.
Probably fell off of a car. No scratches on it. Well, maybe it landed in a bush.
You know, a smart feller could put his knee up on such a thing.
As thin as that imitation leather is, even a bush would take some of it off.
Was it just like that when you found it?
Well, yeah, I angled it 2 degrees to...
Probably belonged to some hitchhiker.
That's a leap of faith.
It might have belonged to the fellow that stole that car and wrecked it.
Go ahead, pick it up, one of you. You know you wanna.
Come on.
Say, look at this.
Well, it looks like Edward R. Murrow's been through here.
I specialize in previously owned cigarette butts.
Half a pack of cigarettes, one unlit.
I can't decide which one to eat. They both look so good.
That suitcase don't belong to any car thief. He was around here too long. I'll take it in. I'll put it in the car for you. Somebody will be around to claim it. See you later, son.
Right, Sheriff.
Son? Wait, he called me son. No wonder Mom cries when I mention the sheriff.
You know, when I look at the human race, I gotta laugh. I got a chickpea for a brain, and I'm still smarter than they are. Go figure. I'll be right back after these words.
Mockingbird Lane.
Well, I'd say it looks like he's early for the panty raid in the dorm.
Well, thank goodness the IHOP's still open, you know?
And cake syrup for everybody.
Well, it's just about time for him to put his knee in. Yep, called it.
How'd you call that?
Ooh la la, rooty tooty, fresh and fruity for me. Hmm? Were you putting your knee up again? Aren't I enough for you?
Hey.
Hey, you're getting dippity-doo in my coat.
I got your phone call.
When I was serving dinner to Mr. Wheeler, he became very angry. He said if I saw you again, he would have me sent back to France.
He can't do that.
Oh, yes, he can. He's my sponsor. He put up the bond.
That was to guarantee that you wouldn't become a ward of the state.
Burt Ward?
Now, we don't have to worry about that. You know how to speak English well enough to get a job anywhere.
Yeah, maybe at a 7-Eleven.
What's he more about?
Nothing.
I don't want to go away, Chase.
You won't have to, honey.
We think it's your fault that Pat went away.
Ling, think whatever he wants to think. Shouldn't take it out on
you. Here, let's go rent the errand boy.
But we hadn't better take any chances. You go back inside. And look, don't worry. Everything's going to be okay.
What the? French people sure do kiss funny.
Mm-hmm. Transportation services provided by Kennedy Limousine. We get you there safe or we don't pay. In Hyannisport and Palm
Beach. It's a speed bump with a tongue.
Whoa.
Wow. He's an excellent driver. Definitely an excellent driver. He's not wearing his underwear.
Man, I've been following you around for days just hoping you might need a tow job.
Yes, yes.
All right.
I'm great. Here, wait a minute. I'll let you look at me full size.
I'm superb. Seven to a box, no corners. I'm a round house. Hmm?
Is there an interpreter in there with you?
Smith. Horatio.
Potato head.
Smith. Oh, yes.
You can call me Sugar Lumps.
How'd you get in the ditch? You fall asleep? Oh, no. There was this big pink and black thing drove right in front of me. It had stripes this wide.
Yeah. Sure. Alcoholism sure is a hoot.
And I'll get your car out. Okay, that sounds like...
Lean on me, baby. Lean.
Get me up here. Yeah. What's he doing?
Hey.
Hey, man, you can't drive this car.
Man.
Fender's cutting the wheel. Sure I can. The motor works, see? But thanks for everything, Dad. You're a cotton picking prince. Okay, just a second. I'll get out of the way.
We thought it would be funny to make a hopeless drunk try to drive a car while it's hooked to a tow truck. Let's watch.
What is it?
It's a State Farm insurance scene. You like it?
This scene is funny.
Wide track tires stabilize your ride.
What is it now?
Oh, that's the Amco theme. That's even better.
Steering wheel won't work.
This strikes me as humorous. Mm-hmm. How can he drive when he's hooked up to a tow truck? The whole concept strikes me as absurd.
I'm driving.
I can't say fire returns.
Get these spiders off me!
Rhythm, huh? I hate a cappella.
Oh, so that's who I am.
Shut up!
I think I'll take after him with that hammer.
Shut up!
Afternoon, Mr. Smith.
Did I do something last night? I'm not going to be proud.
My guys have had their heads chopped off for less than that. For what?
For singing.
So doggone good when I feel so bad. How'd I get here anyway? I told you in this morning, remember?
I told you, but I left your car.
I remember very, very little.
But don't worry, you're a perfect gentleman.
I didn't see any other cars. How'd you ever get me in that bed, anyway?
Who was your cologne?
I carried you in there, and I sat on you till you fell asleep.
Oh, wow.
That must have been quite a chore. You wouldn't have gotten very far in your condition.
It was fun. I didn't mind.
I really appreciate it. Chase Winstead. Chase. Hey. And I, by golly, how much I owe you?
Well, I bent the fender out from the wheel. Want me to fill it in and touch it up for you?
You've touched enough, Chase.
No, I don't think so. I'll get that done when I get back to the city.
Yogurt?
Here, have some coffee. Oh, great. How about $2?
$2? That's outrageous. I'm not paying.
Man, this coffee's worth $2 all by itself. How about the toe? No, I was coming this way anyway. I missed out on a little studying time. Make it $3.
Kid, you're dumber than a bag of hammers.
Sort of. I take a correspondence course in engineering.
Leg up.
Line City Votech.
I really feel indebted to you, and I'd like to do something to pay you back. Now, next time you're in the town, there's my card. Look me up, will you? Will do. Okay. Oh, and by the way.
Here's a Denny's coupon. Good any time after midnight. Enjoy.
Buy yourself a sponge rubber hammer, man. All right, I will. I'll see you, Chase.
Hammer man.
Thank you.
No, thank you.
Oh, no, thank you.
No, thank you.
No, no, please, thank you.
No.
Steamroller Smith, the disc jockey.
Hey, I love your morning show, especially when you make goofy phone calls to celebrities.
220.
That makes $30. Wow.
Well, she swings whenever she sings, blah, blah, da, da, dee, da, bum, bum. Hmm.
Sheriff?
I think you're seeing too much of me.
Have you heard anything from Pat and Liz? No, nothing. Nope. Chase, I'm in a jam, and I need your help. Wheeler swings a big enough stick in this country to make it rough, and he's doing it.
Are you looking on a different script,
Sheriff? I can understand his concern about Pat, but I just don't have a big enough force to comb this area inch by inch.
Is he demanding that?
There was a man killed in a wreck in a small canyon in a big city last year, and it took them 19 days to find him. I don't know what they expect of me.
Yeah, I remember that.
I love your defeatist attitude.
Look, Sheriff, maybe I can get tomorrow off, and I'll get the gang, and we can go out and search that pass. At least you can put that in your report.
And smoke it.
I was hoping you'd say that. I can start at the upper end and work towards you. Can I have your help in another matter?
Sure, what?
You remember how those skid marks just went at right angles to the direction the car was traveling?
Hey, would you drop the skid marks?
Really?
Headquarters think I'm nuts.
Well, then they're
headquarters
not.
Be right.
Didn't you send them that picture?
Well, I'm not the world's greatest photographer. The pictures didn't come out. Can't see the skid marks on the blacktop.
Would you forget the skid marks?
Well, that's what happened. I even wiped up the rubber dust with my fingers.
Okay.
You might have to sign a statement to that effect for me.
You got it. Look, you can even see the bald spots on the tires where they went sideways.
Whoa, don't say bald spot. I'm sensitive.
That's spot, all right. But there's another thing that puzzles me.
Howie Mandel, what's the appeal?
How those tires got off of that car and almost
come on, don't tease us. Put your legs up. You know you want to.
On this wreck, they'd rot. And on my rod, they could prevent a blowout. Maybe even an accident.
Travolta in blowout.
Well, take good care of them in case the owner shows up. Right. See you tomorrow. Right.
What a dink.
Hi, white kids, we were gonna make out here.
Let's call it a day. We've covered half the roads in this county.
Hello, I'm Larry Miller. Yeah. How are you?
How about that ravine? That runs along here for about 8 miles.
Gee, we could really pan out the movie with that ravine.
All right.
As long as I get to be Tig Andrews.
No, we've decided you're already Larry Miller.
Oh.
Sing whatever and eat the teens a single and the little nuns. I'm your boyfriend now.
Darlene, how does that go? Sing when you sling, whatever the thing.
It's close.
Oh, never mind. Hey, honey, Spalding Gray's performing Monster in a Box down here.
No, really?
Oh, I'm big. I'm really big. There's no way to describe just how enormous, but thanks for your patronage. Enjoy this next upcoming event from Hot West. Enjoy.
Honest, they built a fort down here and everything, dear.
Bras popping.
Hey, cut that out.
Oh. That'll hurt. Mm-hmm. See, honey, all this could be yours.
Sure is beat down around here.
Yep.
Look at that.
What is it, Chef?
It's a branch.
Looks like an animal of some sort.
Taylor branch.
Something along here.
You mean a wild animal here?
Sure, could be anything, even a mountain lion.
Meow.
Oh, come on.
Kitty cat.
Now, that was a huge log I was hauling earlier. I'm very immense and huge, believe me. Thanks a lot, and enjoy the rest of the show, and head out to the lobby and enjoy a delicious bonbon. I don't make this noise myself, folks. It's called Foley. I'll be back later with another fun fact. Thanks and enjoy.
Hey, he put on a little weight for the role, just like De Niro.
No, that is De Niro.
He's dedicated. Very, very dedicated.
He's cute.
Yes, but haven't we gone far enough, Chase?
Don't drink that. That's my urine. I don't even do that.
Ooh, that's bitter.
What do you expect?
That's an awful lot of mineral in it.
Come on, let's go.
Oh, wait a minute. Let's take a breather first.
Chase,
he's doing a Gap commercial.
Like, let's go back.
Are you afraid? Now, you come on over here with me. Sit in shade and I'll...
Go into that. Boom! Whoa! Ow. I like to watch. No, do it like this.
Come on, let's go already.
These kids today, I tell ya.
Come on.
Hey, gang, I drank lizard urine.
Ooh. It's Pat's car at the bottom of the wash. Two or three miles back by the old reservoir.
Were they in it?
No, nothing.
So, you called us up for that?
Drive me back to my car and I'll bring up the record.
Did I ever tell you about the 6 levels of drinking? It's really fascinating.
Hello, Crow. Hi, Tom. Hi, Mr. Day here.
Crazy Guggenheim, one of the truly funny drunks.
You know, you just don't see comical drunks like the one in this week's experiment anymore, do you?
Hell, what happened? When did public intoxication stop being funny? Yeah.
Well, I think the 60s were kind of the golden age of the funny drunk. Remember Otis from Mayberry?
Oh, yeah. Sandy, I'll just let myself into the jail.
Hey, what about Dean Martin? He was really funny when he was drunk, wasn't he?
Yeah, he was also very cool. You know, I think it would be a good idea if we each did our kind of favorite funny drunk.
Me first. Okay. I got one already. I'm going to be the guy who calls you, who gets really drunk, calls you at 3 in the morning and tells you what a good friend you are. Okay, Joel, help me out on this. You can do the guy on the other end of the phone.
Okay.
Hello?
Hi, you know what, man? You're a really good friend. No, really. I mean it. You're a good friend. I love you, man. I love you. You're a beautiful person, man. I admire you. You made something of yourself, man.
Joel,
you got out of this town. I think that's great, man.
Joel, bail me out, buddy.
That's very nice, Crow. That's very good. Very funny. Very funny, Crow. And very poignant. Very bittersweet. Tom, you want to do yours?
Well, I'm going to be everybody's favorite funny drunk. I'm going to be the life of the party on New Year's Eve, if you know what I mean. Just imagine now, get this, I have either a lampshade or a fez, perhaps, on my head there, huh? Okay, here we go. Hey, everybody, it's almost midnight. Guess I'll see you next year.
Huh? Oh, my God, my only friend is having a stroke. Oh, Tommy.
Hey, Joel!
What?
Give your rat a gypsy a big slappy wet one, huh?
You guys, stop it. This isn't funny anymore.
Guys, did we just do an after-school special here?
Well, I don't think so. I haven't seen Scott Baio on the premises.
Well, actually, since we've moved into that genre, I think it's time to do the pointy and thoughtful ending, don't you?
Yeah, I guess so.
Rarely have we seen a person fail who has thoroughly followed our path. Our stories disclose in a general way what happened, what we were like, and what we are like now.
We got 37! It's going
wrong! Turn the motor on. Winch is already engaged. Now if I yell, turn the key off.
Okay.
Now, what's this guy doing?
No. The steering wheel's on the other side. What are you, from Europe or something?
Okay, go ahead.
Should they go backwards?
Go ahead.
I thought you said go backwards.
That's right, go ahead. Yes.
But should they go left?
Right.
Tell me, should they go left?
Right.
That's what I'm asking!
Right!
So
no left! Ladies and gentlemen, join us next week for another edition of Abbott and Costello Playhouse. Good one, girl.
Folks, I tried to get them to rewrite this scene. Next time, I'll insist on Final Cut. Enjoy my special spring project.
Roll it over on us now! Hey, you really get a sense of where that monster is, don't you?
Yeah. I'll be using this condescending tone till the mid-70s.
Yeah. We'll meet you back at the garage, okay? Okay, let's go, Jenny.
Can't that woman use a door?
I sing whenever... Oh, no, I'm doing it. Oh.
You're like a cheese shredder.
Well, I'm getting really hungry. I've got to stop letting them get away, folks. Until next time, good night and God bless.
So the entire town revolves around the towing business.
Yep, pretty much.
See you later.
He sings whenever he sings, whenever he sings. Ah, forget it.
Hi, you guys fixing cars? Can I hang around some?
Where did you find them? By the reservoir and Williams Wash. They weren't in it. No sign of blood or anything.
Neat.
No, I think they were thrown clear.
Did you search the area?
Yeah,
isn't that your job?
We went down the ravine for about a mile and we looked beyond the wreck for a couple hundred yards. Wouldn't you say, Gordy? At least that far.
Did you see any footprints?
No, none.
Looks like Tig Andrews in the middle there.
No, it's Larry Miller.
Larry Miller, huh?
About the same as that sedan. Like it's been hit with a 10-ton rubber mount.
Is that a fantasy of yours, Sheriff?
Pretty rough trip down that cliff, but could have done it.
Yeah. I'll have to go over that area with a rake.
You are a rake.
You know, I've been thinking, if Liz and Pat had eloped, they wouldn't have taken his car. His old man Wheeler'd have it traced right off.
Mm-hmm. Well, maybe he stored it, Chase, and then it was stolen.
Larry Miller, ladies and gentlemen.
If it was stolen, somebody parked it there. Well, the brakes could have faded and it rolled off the edge.
It would be a strange coincidence if they came back to this part of the county. Yep. Possibility makes some sense, though. Yep. I'll get my gear and dust for fingerprints.
Oh, Rochester, will you dust the truck?
Gosh, I wish you boys had called me before you drug it out. I might have found some clues to help us out.
Yeah, like you could find a clue.
The hard part's telling Mr. Winter. I sure dread that.
It's not like we found them there.
Nope.
He's sure gonna raise Ned, because I didn't find this wreck sooner.
Ned? Raise Ned?
Where's Mr. Condon?
Oh, he went down to the field with a load of fuel oil. Back in 2 or 3 hours. I'm gonna close up.
I'll see you later.
I know. That's what I'm afraid of.
Real change, folks.
It's the wages of fear.
Well, I sing whenever I sing, whenever she sings.
Whoa! Wow, the first cool thing in the movie!
I just know I'm gonna take the blame for this, and I wasn't even close.
Meanwhile, back at the Joad house.
Hi, Mom. You mean?
Sorry, I'm late.
Just a minute, not so fast there.
What for?
Playing right guard, Mom?
Did you ever play football?
With the Green Bay Packers.
Oh, that's not right. Picking up your mom and playing football with her. That's wrong.
All right,
crazy people.
Oedipus, you put me down. You poke your eyes out.
Keep them closed. Silly.
Uh-oh.
Look what Lisa got me. Stay there, Chase. Watch.
Tugging at the heartstrings. This isn't fair.
I thought you meant braces on your teeth, honey.
No. Oh, take them back. They don't work.
Chase. I can get up.
Oh, so tender. Oh, that's so cute.
I can't. Well, our braces shorted out the house.
Oh,
that was wonderful, baby. Just wonderful.
I've been pregnant all afternoon. Ever since Lisa brought the braces over. And it walked all the way, twice. I want to do it right for you.
Uh-huh, that's neat. Who's your friend?
Okay, back in the case.
Silly chatterbox, you're on the wrong feet.
There was a mushroom.
Wait, it's Rafi.
Sad little mushroom.
He really did come with a banjo on his knee.
Ready to cry. There was a sparrow.
Gray, I'm gonna go listen to my cat scream.
There was an eagle.
There was a tow truck operator who couldn't sing to save his life.
The Lord said, Children laugh.
Ouch, tough room.
She's trying to push him into the cornfield right now.
And all that is left to complete the job.
If it wasn't for the blue tail fire,
I have to smile as my brother.
And there was a garden.
I got a fast tow truck.
Beautiful garden.
Always improvising now.
Of a world without joy.
Hey, thanks for cheering us up.
And then there was laughter.
Well, we assume
wonderful
that.
Wonderful laughter. For he created.
Boy, you know, I just love a Sammy Condor.
Mm-hmm.
And the Lord said, oh, laugh. Children laugh.
This is the Chapin brother they don't talk about.
I'm gonna kill him.
Whoa, he's going into his head voice.
Yep, smells like teen spirit. Mm-hmm.
Take it home, brother. Please.
No, not the coda, no!
Oh, that's real nice, but it doesn't help my legs.
Laughing's important, isn't it, Chase?
Oh, it sure is. And you know, I never felt any more like laughing than I do. Like,
thanks a lot.
I didn't think you'd be able to do that good in a week.
Didn't you, really?
Honest, but you know, you're going to have to work real hard. And you mustn't be disappointed. It takes a long time. Okay?
Now, scram. I got a dame here.
Too bit. Do I have to, Chase?
You sure do.
Yep.
Show me how you can walk.
Get out before he starts playing again.
Good night.
You little grandstander, you. You gotta love her.
Don't ever sing that song again.
It was a wonderful thing for you to do, Lisa.
I wanted to.
Now you're broke, aren't you?
No, but my spirit is.
Pop's gonna pick him up in the morning.
I know. When you showed me that money, I was afraid you'd get it first.
Well, I'm still going to pay you for it.
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
Yes.
Hello.
How are things at headquarters?
Well, you should have been back an hour ago.
Hmm? He's phoning in his lines.
Where? That's awful. No, it couldn't be Mr. Compton.
You don't say.
All right.
You don't say.
At the garage? All right, I'm leaving now.
You don't say.
What is it?
He didn't say.
Oh,
I love that.
Honey, I'm awfully sorry, but I've got to leave.
Here he comes now, Sheriff.
Hide the flask.
Come on.
All
right. Wait a minute, Sheriff. You got a sore foot.
Oh, no.
Huh? Gotta shoot him. Oh.
Take my Model A. She's old, shiny, brown.
Oh, well, shut up, come Cookie on, Pants. Get in.
No, I didn't see it, but I sure heard about it. Can I open this thing up?
No, yeah, but I'm flattered.
Check your rims. Let's get going.
Let's do the next scene down at the gay ride.
Hey, on three, let's throw the old guy out, huh? Ready? One, two. Oh, we're here already. Chinese fire drill, everybody out.
Ah, geez, absolutely no salvage with this one.
Ah, look at the poor guy. Hmm, let's stick some cloves in him.
Mm. Tires look good.
Mm.
Be careful, it's pretty hot.
He's not in it.
He may have been hurt and crawled away.
Sheriff, face the fact, the guy's dead.
Okay, Compton! Mr. Compton!
Just look for a burning guy.
Find anything, Sheriff?
Let's go over this again. How did you get into the act?
Nope, here comes the vaudeville routine.
Tell me again.
What's on second?
Well, I can barrel along in my Model A.
She don't look like much now, but she was a beauty when I first
the
got
accident.
No. Get up to 60.
The accident. Yes, the accident.
Just the facts, ma'am.
Well,
I'll tell you.
I wish you would.
What's on second?
Seen the headlights coming up the grade towards you. And all of a sudden, they come to go and...
These two are just glowing, aren't they?
She blew up. Well, he seen somebody is in a mite of trouble, so he come in the store talking about it. That's when I offered to call you.
Yep.
Did you get
Don't ever touch me.
No.
Did he see anything else?
Nope.
Nope.
Can you see me?
You want to wait in the car for us?
No.
Is there a point to your little story?
Hey, Sheriff, okay. Let you say all the way you're going to obey the law.
Thank you.
I'm hungry.
Chase.
Oh, now here comes Zeppo.
Oh, nothing.
Here comes this guy.
Pat and Liz might have a look.
What's he about?
But Compton ought to be around here.
Maybe he's in the hospital.
No. I checked there before I left my place. Would Compton have any reason to want to get lost?
No, none that I can think of.
You would have no reason to know about this, but there's been a lot of livestock missing lately.
Another one plot? Here, oh, man!
That doesn't make headlines, but now it's people.
Mm-hmm. You think there's a tie-up?
I don't know. What we need is a criminal investigator, and headquarters won't send one.
Do we maybe have a sheriff in the vicinity?
Well, maybe they will now.
Yeah, maybe. Did you notice those skid marks?
Would you forget the skid marks?
If it had been hit by another vehicle, the paint would be knocked off. What batters a car around like it was a toy?
My wife! Good night, everybody! Enjoy the meal!
How's Bart coming along with the party? All right.
By the way, the stove's on.
Say, you and Chase sure got off light. You took off this morning. You've just been sitting around here on your can all day long. That barn was a place to clean. You get the high five set up? Yeah.
Well, you steamboats and dreamboats, that's
what's steamroller
on another session. Steamroller here at KILT. Any of you round rocks get
Can't
bonus.
Stand that teen slang. Turn
I'll
to Paul Harvey.
I'll be a flatter party tonight out at Hargitay's barn on Route 43. Drop in. I'll flatten you.
What?
Hey, man, that's us. We got the steamroller coming out. That's where Chase has been all day. Getting steamrolled. This will be a blast. How about that guy?
Man, was the Richard Speck a popular haircut back then?
Oh, the door's jammed. see. That's why it's got a...
I love that door. Really works well.
Mm-hmm. Hey, little man, you sure had a busy day.
Little man.
Getting a paint job and Steamroller Smith.
Snuffy Smith?
Now, how'd you guys find out about Steamroller Smith? Well, he just said so on his program. Said it right out on the network.
Yep.
Oh, I wanted it to be a surprise. Well, come on, don't spread it around, huh?
Yeah, wash your hands.
Really?
How are the preparations coming? Oh, that'll be finished about 45 minutes. The gang won't start arriving from
east. No, that's 30. Wait.
We're under the wire with time to spare. No sweat.
We now return to Three Jacks and a Jill.
Good, he's gonna get it.
Oh, and he's drinking turtle wax. Ooh.
Headed to O-Bar.
Oh, I hate the ground you walk on, little darling. For all them things that you have did to me. Oh, you nag me till you hold.
Rampa Jones, ladies and gentlemen.
I know you feel bad, Mr. Gower.
And I'll forget your memory.
Please kill him, please.
Hey, Grib. Good.
Things make sense when you're all liquored up. It's fun.
Remember, Chief.
Come on, Cassie Bell. Let's go.
Cassie Bell?
Stupid man, more powerful than an Ookie motive.
Oh, I've seen this. Now, this is the last scene from Crazy Larry and Dirty Mary, remember? Huh?
Home Alone!
Oh,
yes. Well, look out, everybody, there's a forked tongue in the road.
That's me. I did that, sorry.
Billy Go, get off my bridge.
It's the Soul Train. Ooh. Three.
We're traveling on the engine on the Happy Day Express. The letters on the engine say J-E-S-U-S.
I like butter. Look, my chin's yellow. That means I like butter. Why is he driving in a riverbed?
It's me.
Hey, look, a hand up there.
The director, folks.
Ooh.
Didn't see it. Never saw it. Nope. Not gonna get involved. Gonna act like I'm in New York City. Turn around. Get the heck out of here. Nope. Bye, Nick.
Where's the dining car?
Hey, there's meat on the inside.
Barbecue. Oh, I don't know where to begin. It all looks so good.
Fava beans.
Something real strange must have happened.
If you'd like to make a call, please hang up and dial again.
You'll be handy if you want it.
Yep, I'm rubbing my belly right now.
Sit down, Harris.
Ah, Cramity, pull up your pants and sit down.
Hey, watch the feet,
You be going down to the wreck, Sheriff? No, that's not my territory.
What is your territory?
I have a report. The troopers will take care of that. Harris, tell me again about the train wreck.
Well, the wreck of the old
I was driving on flat lag in my Model A. Bought it at 32 for six. Just a minute. I asked you what time it is, and you tell me how to build a clock. Just the facts about the wreck.
You got me.
I was driving along quiet like in the wreck. Then I turned around and come back down here and told you about it. Give me your keys, Harris. Thank you.
Hey.
What for? You're spinning a yarn like that and driving while drunk.
Room 310, I'll be there after
that. I demand a sobriety test. That does it. Go lock yourself.
Hey, you're under arrest.
I demand a sobriety test because I ain't been drinking.
Thank you, Senator. Your statement has been duly noted.
Believe that is not heavy.
Out, baby. Out.
Whatever you think's right. Put your hands up.
Don't you see what you're doing to me?
Can't win them all, can't you?
Haven't met before. Is this your bottle?
Wife. You want to have?
Amazing.
What? That's the only wife I need.
Well, nothing wrong with me having a bit. Little tittle here.
Ugh, blue cheese flavored vodka.
What do you mean topsoil's gone? What do you mean they moved?
Well, Ma.
Lisa, I'm home.
My baby's you
no!
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 Rocks whenever she talks. My baby's
took a bite out of that doily.
I'm joining the circus.
I'm going to spend the night with the Blackwells. Mommy said it was all right. Will you take me over?
Well, I don't know, Missy. Gosh, that's 2 or 3 miles out.
Before she couldn't walk. Now she's hauling furniture.
Oh, sure.
Kid tipping.
Sheriff, what in the world have you done to that car of yours?
It's a new fuel mixture. You like it?
I just barely touched the gas pedal and the back wheel started to spin. Well, I was two blocks down the road before I even knew I'd left home.
Come on, Mom. I'm just trying to make a hot rodder out of you.
Hmm? Hey, it's Oedipus on wheels.
Okay. Is there a phone on every wall?
Hello. Yeah, hello, Sheriff. A what? Book on reptiles.
Sheriff, you're breathing all funny.
I still have it around here somewhere. Yeah, sure.
Got your leg up?
I have to take Missy over by the Blackwells. I'll stop by on my way to pick up Lisa. Okay?
Okay.
He's a queer duck.
Well, now I'm going to tell you something you don't know.
Your mother's a guy.
I've been talking to a zoologist. And the Gila monster's size is controlled, like everything else, by a sort of thyroid or pituitary gland. Sometimes a change in diet can throw the balance all out of whack. Either the cells break down too fast or build up too slow.
I got the problem,
the
too.
Makes either runts or giants out of them.
Good, but what's that mean to me?
Trouble.
The zoologist also told me about a doctor who just found the bones of some huge animals down in Tanganyika. Mm-hmm. And the theory was that, they lived in kind of river delta.
You're really deep.
Certain salts had washed into the valley, been absorbed by the plants, and then transferred to the animals, causing them to be giants.
Hmm.
Well, I know. I probably sound a little bit like Harris, but let me tell the whole thing in my own words.
Norman Rockwell, Sheriff.
There was another report out of Russia or the Ukraine.
Brazil or something.
It was in the paper a couple of months ago. Maybe you saw it. About a baby that weighed 130 pounds when it was 10 months old and was taller than its mother?
What, you think I'm illiterate? I read the Inquirer.
Supposed to be a giant.
Yeah, and that same thing could happen right here. Did you see any footprints around any of those wrecks?
Well, Glenn is 50 feet tall.
No. Gila monster footprints?
Yeah, a big one, about the size of a bus.
Lonnie Anderson's bus?
Are you serious?
I'm so sorry.
Well,
I'm in shame.
Harris saw it. Some of the survivors of the train wreck saw it. A giant lizard.
Train wreck? Where?
At the bridge over
Wilson's 10 people in this
water.
Town and there's no great...
When? Plan?
Tonight, about an hour ago.
Why?
Troopers were inclined to pass it off as shock or optical illusion. You can't always believe what Harris said.
Nope. I'll just let him ramble before I chop him off at the knees.
And black stripes.
Could be that peyote
no,
I handed
I told a guy
out.
In the other day. And he said he'd been forced off the road by something like that. I didn't believe him because he'd been drinking.
We've all been drinking.
And another thing. When we were looking for Pat's car, we saw where something had been drugged down the wash.
Hmm?
You know, if they could have gotten that big,
then
could have knocked
I
Mr.
can get
Thompson's
that
truck
big.
Off that road.
Hmm.
Could have gotten him.
Oh, my thinker hurts.
Don't look at those. They're not real.
I shouldn't have told you about this until after the party, but I just thought you'd want to know.
Hadn't we better warn everybody?
No.
That would be telling.
It operates in and around the wash. Troopers have got that staked out for a couple of miles. Just keep it to yourself. It might cause panic.
Okay, Sheriff, whatever you say.
If I don't tell, I'll just bust.
Try and forget it for now and have some fun, will you, boy?
Yeah, sorry about the train wreck. Go enjoy yourself. Live the high life, you know?
Oh, it's the annual fire hazard dance.
Oh, Hackin', we're gonna miss the barn raising. Shame, really.
Do in the butt. Tow truck driver got a big old butt. Do in the butt.
Well, hello. I'm so glad you could join me. I'm your host, Thomas Servo, and this is Servo on Cinema. This week, director Ray Kellogg. Ray Kellogg, of course, was...
Excuse me, Tom. We've only got the one camera cam bot, okay?
Oh, of course. Thank you. Ray Kellogg. Much like his good friend Orson Welles, Kellogg's career was short-circuited by his enormous ego and his difficulties in holding to a budget. For example, in today's film, the Gila Monster effect, achieved with the use of a normal-sized Gila Monster and detailed sets filled with twigs and matchbox cars, and it was enormously expensive, and there was virtually no money left for blocking. But Kellogg...
Don't you think you should say a word to the audience about what blocking is, maybe?
Hey, don't mind me. It's only my show.
Well, good. I'm glad you said that. People of Earth, blocking is a technique used by directors to tell his actors where to stand or maybe what to do with their bodies.
Like in today's film. You'll excuse me, Tom.
Sure, fine.
Well, the director just had the actors put their legs up on everything.
I was getting to that. You see, it's called the leg-up position.
Maybe the leg-up position is cheap, but for Pete's sake, they're unrelenting. They put their legs up on pipes,
stop
on
it.
Benches,
Joel,
on edges,
stop.
On
stop. Stop. But you're
really
talking
about
the
inappropriate times, too.
This is his thing, you know, so.
Oh, sorry.
Thank you, Joel. Beat it, buddy. Well, I thank you. Without further ado, a short film by Cambot, a tribute to the blocking techniques of director Ray Kellogg, known for the firmness of his leg-up position.
Suitcases on each other. Oh!
Oh!
Have you seen Point Break yet?
Oh, no, but I understand Swayze does just about all his own stunts.
Yep, 100% pure adrenaline.
What about Next of Kin?
I love that, the arrow shooting sequence. I didn't like Ghost too much. Jeez, what's with him?
I hold it!
For fun.
Hold it all you've got with me!
That was very fun.
Now I got a surprise for you. We got the king of the DJs.
Oh, man, I hate it when seniors
now
keep coming back.
You've all heard the Nutty Platter Show on KILT. That's right.
Yeah, we're going to do a nutty wake-up call to Marty Ingles.
Seagile, everybody, Seagile.
Okay, your old dad here has some small words and some great records. I want you to have a ball tonight. Let's begin with one of the top Kilt Survey songs. What do you say now? Let's everybody dance. Here we go.
No. This guy really earns a salary, doesn't he?
Shake your forbidden parts.
Ooh, yeah.
When the caddy's rocking, don't bother knocking.
Conrad Bain.
Now, do you mind telling me what this is all about? Have you been down to the train wreck?
No. I'm a sheriff. What would I be down there for?
I talked to a trooper about my son's car.
What, he's selling his kid's car already?
It shouldn't have been moved until a thorough investigation had been made, and it had been photographed.
Wait a minute, Conrad. You're wearing pants under that coat?
It wasn't done, was it, Sheriff? I thought not. It was removed and clues lost without authority. Hmm. You didn't put that in your report, did you, Sheriff? Of course you didn't. And I'll tell you why.
Because you're Earl Warren.
You were protecting that Chase Winston. Covering him regardless of the effect it might have on others.
Chase Winston's a real booster.
Chase was only trying to help. He's your son's friend. Probably the best one he ever had. Of course it wasn't in the report. What good would it do?
Nobody reads those things.
Any kid can make a mistake, Mr. Wheeler. Even yours. But Sheriff, it's my son that's missing.
Oh, throw that one up at me. Twist the knife, why don't you?
Let me
Ouch.
Ask you something else.
Are you a real sheriff?
Have you heard the reports about a giant lizard?
Yep, out of my jurisdiction.
You believe him? I don't know, Mr. Wheeler. Doesn't seem possible.
You?
Well, why not? There have been giants before.
There might be giants.
True. But how could anything that big go unnoticed in this area? Have you ever walked the length of Williams Wash? No.
Not naked.
You know anybody that has? No. That area is so choked with underbrush, it isn't even good hunting ground. And I say it is possible for a giant lizard to have lived there for years without being seen.
Well, you're high, Conrad.
No.
This this guy? He's like a puppet made by Sid and Marty Croft. He hardly moves.
My son's dead.
Yep.
So is Compton. I can't blame you for what's happened to Pat, but Compton's death is on your hands.
How did you come to that conclusion?
I'll tell you how.
I thought it was found
only 2 miles beyond Pat's car. And if you'd investigated that area thoroughly, as you're paid to do, Compton might not have died.
Oh, quit funning me.
Well, now come out here. I want to show you something else.
Uh-oh.
You call this fixed?
Now, something may have hit this car, but it didn't take the tires off. Hmm. And where did those new white sidewalls on Chase Winston's hot rod come from?
The lizard runs a chop shop?
There was a towing charge against
him. He presumed the bill wouldn't be paid, so he borrowed the tires in the meantime?
Perhaps.
That's thievery. Destroying evidence, obstructing justice. Now, your last official act of office will be to arrest that boy and bring him in. And I'll go along to make sure...
powerful gesture again.
You got me on that one.
It sounds like a slow version of these boots are made for walking.
Are you ready to walk, boots? Oh, I hate my life. Carson Pirate.
Charo is playing.
You mean Charo in charge?
Yeah.
Barnaby Jones, epilogue.
It's a teen grope fest. Woo!
Hey, the wallflower's here.
Who invited King Curtis?
Must be related to the producer, Ken Curtis.
Hey, kids, a fellow dropped in over KILT the other day.
He offered me coke to play his record.
I had a great new song. I thought it was just fine. I want to play it for you. We got a little pickup group together and cut a demo disc on it. I want to play it for you now and see what you think about it.
It'll really make you want to gyrate.
The first person who identifies the singer on the record gets 2 free rides on my elephant in Bangkok, Siam. But you got to pay your own way over there and back.
Ooh, the stinger. Ouch.
Now see what you think of it.
It's Dionne Warwick.
Dead Kennedys?
No, it's a 1910 fruit gum factory.
Dreads up there?
No, nothing like that. No, they
are made of that
way. Whoa! Ty Andrews dancing up a storm.
Oh, Larry Miller.
Larry Miller.
Hey, there's Jessica Tandy back in the back there.
She's dandy.
Hey, don't rush the stage.
Get out of your tar and feathers yet. I'm going to play the rest of it. How do you like?
It's got a good beat and it's easy to dance to.
The singer, Elvis.
David Soul.
John Travolta.
Johnny Rivers.
Art Garfunkel.
Terrence Trent D'Arby.
Johnny Thunders.
Look, the same guy you hear singing on the record also wrote the song. Now who is it? Does anybody know?
Bobby Goldsboro?
Okay. It's going to come out on records in a couple of months, and you can find his name on the label.
Oh, we can't read.
Oh, come on.
Qu'est-ce que c'est, Gary Lewis and the Playboys?
Sam did it.
Kill him.
Why didn't you say something?
You didn't tell us.
Well, I didn't know there was anything I'd want to admit to.
Yeah, well, don't quit your toe job.
Oh, this is sweet. Just like when Vicki Lawrence won the Grammy on the Carol Burnett Show.
Thank you very much.
Also,
thank you.
The other day, Chase played me another little song. It's kind of different from this one.
Different.
But I imagine with a little coaxing, you know, by hitting your hands together like this, you might give you a little preview of it. What do you say?
Oh, you mean like this?
Yeah, you should have washed it in cold water.
It's a personal pan banjo.
Tiptoe through the tulips.
Hey, see if you can get your gun back from the bouncer.
Children laugh, the Lord said laugh, children laugh.
And the Lord said, taste my lizard steel.
Tonight on Night Gallery, Lillian Hellman, Edward R. Murrow, and I will sneak a smoke behind the barn.
I'd say music hath charms to annoy a savage beast.
So, Sheriff, ready to do-si-do?
Matchbox, save them.
Oh,
those
are Hot Wheels.
Corgis, maybe.
Sizzlers.
Why, you brought the party to a complete halt.
I'm guessing this is the extended boredom mix.
Okay, just blend in.
We're from the committee to keep rock and roll white.
Just a minute.
It gets better.
I just want to know if the Lord said it this many times in a row.
That's why the Deuteronomy is so long.
Wow.
It's Jack Ruby!
And the Lord said, die, children, die. La, 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 la.
Hey, I forgot to stamp my hand.
It is Zimmer.
Ouch, quit pushing back there. Ah!
He couldn't hit the broadside of a barn dance.
Ow. Ow. Ow.
Oh. Hey, leave me alone. I paid to cover.
I can take a hint. I don't need a barn to fall on me.
Margot Hemingway in lipstick.
Yeah, I'm going back to Jurassic Park. Ah, fooey on you, crummy townspeople. Ah!
Well, he plumb crawled out of my jurisdiction.
What'll it take to stop that thing? I don't know, but I'm going down to the train wreck and get some troopers. If we pump enough lead into that thing, we may hit a vulnerable spot.
Don't,
well, you're gonna have to
give
me a hand. But how? Keep these kids here. I don't want anybody roaming around.
Where are we going?
Wild rebels.
Look at him rip off there. Look at him go.
You've been after this, now you've got it.
He pinned me.
Listen, kids, Wheeler's my deputy. You'll take your orders from him. Hey. Arrest anybody that tries to get away.
1 hour deputizing.
All right, you're arrested.
Sheriff says this is a place to stay. Well, we're not staying here.
That's right.
I'll have to arrest anyone that leaves.
Don't worry.
Now let's do the serenity prayer. Lord, please help me to accept the...
We now return to Bearcats with Rod Taylor and Dennis Cole.
We'll try reasoning with them.
Oh, it's everything you said it was and more.
Take these keys and wait inside the office till I get back.
You want a sandwich? Stewart sandwich? Microwave burrito? Bagel dog?
Mom, how'd you get the knot untied?
I leave the door open. Let me see light.
I told you to wait inside. Why don't you do what I tell you? I haven't got much time.
You're not going to leave me, Chet. I'm going to help.
Do you know what's in here? Nitroglycerin, enough to blow up half this town.
It doesn't matter. I'm still going to help.
But she can speak English all of a sudden.
All right. Now take these, hold them, and don't let them bump. And for heaven's sakes, don't drop.
Mom, I'll be back later to muck you out, okay?
Mom, please leave the light on.
Oh, it's the other leading brand of nitro.
Now hold those.
Hey, Joel, now he's driving a nitro-burning funny car.
Left, no, right, no, no. So how do you like Berkeley?
This is Gila country, you beware.
No, no, it's the field. Whip, Richard,
oh, you got through here, all right. Now, they generally travel in a straight line.
Unless they're hammered.
Good Lord, he's hit the Blackwell home. That's where Missy is.
What does the Lord say about that?
This is Blackwell.
Can Gila come out and play?
Missy.
Oh, this is the Escher house. He thinks he went all the way through.
Missy!
Mary,
you, don't you know me?
That nitro, we're cutting across.
Fasten your seatbelts, it's gonna be a bumpy night.
And why?
Oh, forget it.
Gotta drain a lizard. Gonna go drain a lizard. That's what I'm doing. Yep.
Oh, it's the Evil Dead all of a sudden.
Look out.
It's all right, Missy. It's all right. Lisa, get Missy and hold her down. Both of you lie flat.
Get in here with the nitro. It's safe.
If you're unsure and it's the 50s, duck and cover.
Mm-hmm. I will prevail. I'm a survivor like Cher.
It's go time. Let's party. I saw this coming a long way away.
The horror. The horror.
Ooh. Oh, they killed off the only likable character.
Golf shoes for everybody.
I dubbed this spot's luggage world.
I love the smell of lizard in the morning. Smells like chicken.
I'm still here, Happer. You crap hound.
Oh, here comes Johnny on the spot now. Great.
Yeah, these are out-of-state boys. They arrested me. I was out of my jurisdiction, don't you know?
Are you all right?
I'm bitter, Mommy.
That's okay, honey.
I tore my new dress.
Oh, we can get you a new dress.
It's coming out of your allowance.
Everybody all right?
Oh, we make a nice
wedding. Yeah.
You?
Ow!
On the way back, we picked up his trail. Followed him across country.
Oh, good. Adley Stevenson is
what
here.
What did you hit him with?
Everything I had.
My brand new 100% completed hot rod.
That too.
I had to start in the next county to
all
get
right,
up enough
I miss?
Momentum to do that to him. Not with 4 quarts of nitroglycerin, right? Hmm? You rode across that rough field carrying nitro?
Yes, good job, sir. McLeod.
You know what could have happened to you?
It did. I lost my car.
Oh, don't worry about that. Railroad will be glad to buy you a new one.
And the upholstery, of course, will be from Gila and Gila of Beverly Hills.
Rod Chase, did you see it?
I sure did, Missy. You were really traveling.
Like Holly Go Lightly?
Yeah.
Hey, teeners, we found a new place to park and party.
Keep those kids up at the barn. Well, how do you arrest a bunch of kids going in all different directions?
Easy, tear gas.
What happened if that thing had turned back? Same thing that happened to Pat. Sheriff, your job is a much bigger one than I thought.
So is your gut.
Since Compton's gone, I guess Chase is out of a job. That's right. Would you make it a point to have the boy come around and see me in the morning? I'll bring him around in the morning.
Next time on the ABC Movie of the Week, Clint Howard in Killdozer.
The sheriff will be back in Gila 2, The Revenge. This time it's personal.
Chase, take us out with a song.
Little more there. Little more. Bring it down. Bring it down. Little more.
Two. Okay, hey, check under my... Hey, Cambot, I need a little more monitor up here.
Two.
Hey, just a second, Tom. We're going to go through the song list now, okay?
Okay, sure. Mm-hmm.
Two. Okay. Mm-hmm. Now, this is the way I see it. We're going to start with the stuff we know. We're going to do that. Eric Burdon, mm-hmm. I'm going to ride the serpent. Mm-hmm. Okay. And then that's followed by
Cold-Blooded,
right? Yeah, and Crow.
No. It's mm-hmm. Newt.
I'm sorry, Newt, but we're not going to be able to do Karma Chameleon mm-hmm. for this show. Okay?
Told you, Newt.
Okay, so we do the lineup as is. Uh-huh. We start with the stuff we know, followed by the stuff we don't know, mm-hmm. followed by Tom Servo's...
No, I'm the Gecko.
The Gecko's touching and heartfelt yeah. version of It's Not Easy Being Green, kind of like the way that Buddy Rich did it on The Tonight Show.
Exactly.
Okay? And then finally, for the finale act, Crow, I mean the Newt, we'll do the Gene Simmons tongue thing, okay?
All right. Woo, let's
Look at that tongue action. La, 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 la,
la. Say, guys, I hate to be the flat tire in your tour bus. I mean, I don't want you to think that I'm the aspirated vomitus.
What is your point, Crow?
Well, aren't we just doing the same stuff we did when we were Spidor?
What?
You know, the glam rock power trio from Earth versus the Spider. It's the same thing.
No way, man. We're going in completely different directions here. The lineup's different. The instruments are the same.
These helmets are new. The sign
in it. It's pretty lame, isn't it? We should just go ahead and read a letter.
It was kind of a dumb idea. Okay, well, here we go. We got the letters. People always seem to like that. Okay, this is from, get that on still story. This is from Shannon,
age four.
It says, Shannon likes your show, and it reads Gypsy, mm-hmm. Joel, Tom, and then Crow is Art.
Art?
She thinks you're Art. Okay, and then we got another one here. Let's put that on still story. Ooh, this one reads, Dear Joe and Bots.
Bots, that's us!
Woo! Oh, we're the Bots! Woo! We're the Bots!
Thank you.
I just love you little guys. I like that way. Tom Serbo sings, my favorite robot is Crow, but Joe is funny too. And it's signed, TV's Frank?
Oh!
Yes! Yes! What a little kiss up. Push the button, TV's Frank.
Oh, little John, have you seen my arrow?